Another lifesaver.
Stay tuned. The MRT.
Yes.
It's a lifesaver.
Another lifesaver.
Well, it's not built yet, so, you know, maybe it's too early to tell.
But again, I need MRT because it's a lifesaver. Oh, I should tweet that.
You should tweet that,
I should tweet that.
Okay, now, I'll bring you back to that survey that we talked about earlier on the show. Yahoo Malaysia did a survey and poll on Budget 2013 asking you Malaysians what you think we should have. Better public transport or cheaper cars? More people voted for cheaper cars.
Well, they're not green conscious then.
They're not green conscious. One, or maybe they've been disenfranchised with the way public transport's been as of late.
True.
But that's all about the change with the MRT. So let's bring on our guest
in the studio. Let's say hello to Mr. Amin Mahmood Razak,
who is the Director of Strategic Communication at MRT.
Yes.
What does MRT stand for?
I was about to say something else, but it's actually Mass Rapid Transit. And you're going to ask me why, what's the difference in MRT and LRT?
Yes.
So the LRT is has a smaller capacity in the context of the, its what it defines. But in Malaysia, the LRT does not go into the city per se, but the MRT will cut through the city centre, will go right smack into the heart of Kuala Lumpur and Bukit Bintang and Jalan Sultan and Pudu areas, you know, Cochrane. So this is a big difference, reducing the amount of cars that go into the city, even though the poll says that a lot of Malaysians prefer cheaper cars. And I think it's a paradigm shift that we need to do. Because in Hong Kong, people do not own cars, they own assets.
Yes.
Because the network of MRTs there is tremendous.
You know, I think in Malaysia, people want cheaper everything.
Yeah.
It's a mindset.
Okay. So much so, when it comes to the MRT, the cost is not justifiable by ticket purchase per se.
No,
it's not, because it's humongous.
Yeah.
It's more justifiable in terms of economic value, which people would get, how the city benefits from it. So tell us a bit about how comparable is our MRT going to be to the one in our neighboring country, Singapore?
We are benchmarking it against the best of Hong Kong and Singapore in this region. And of course, London started building this 146 years ago, you know, underground. So we are going to have the best of the technology can offer today. Our trains, for example, are going to be 30% lighter, so there's less strain on the track, less noise, lower noise trains. We're going to have the best communications technology that we can offer now. Because remember, when we built the LRT, this was the 20th century. We could say it was the 1900s if you like. This is going to be the 21st century. So we are gearing up for a system which will be up to date and technologically ready to serve 20,000 people in Kuala Lumpur per hour per direction.
Wow.
That's a lot. That's a lot. That means
lot.
That's based on 3.5, one train every 3.5 minutes. And if we have full capacity of 1,200 people in the trains, that's 20,500 people per hour per direction. And if you go in the mornings, you know, there's one you in the car, there's another guy in the other car. So that's technically about 20,000 cars off the road, and
yes,
that will be tremendous.
True, that's true.
Yep, so no more exchanging numbers with the hot chick and the jam next to you.
You can do it on the MRT.
On the MRT, there you go, more physical contact.
Boys, come on. Okay, the main objective of the contest, I Need MRT.
Yeah. Okay, I Need MRT was devised because we found that when we did our public display last year, we found that there was an approval rating of 91%. But a lot of the news you read is people getting angry with the MRT or not liking, because obviously there are some land acquisition issues, you know. So we needed to give a platform for people to speak positively about the system. So we devised this contest where you tell us, instead of us telling you why you need MRT, jams, cheaper on the wallet, you know, parking problems, let you tell us what exactly is the reason you need to have the MRT. Put in a creative picture or a caricature or drawing, which you have copyrights to, and we'll pay you. But more importantly, we'll make you famous because we'll use the winning entry as our corporate advertisement.
I see.
Across Malaysia and across our billboards.
That's so interesting. So your ad will be famous, basically.
Yes, and it's publicly voted on the website mrtmyride.com.my. People will vote for it, and we have some leading contenders right now. I think we're close to 3 weeks now. We've have about almost 1,000 entries. And more than 5,000 votes, and that's amazing in the sense of response. And we expected this because we know there's people out there who like and want the system. But okay, you know, if you like something, you're not going to write to the people, "Oh, I really like the roti canai."
No. You tell someone about it.
But if your roti canai has something inside it, you're going to write them to the newspaper that roti canai had some bad things inside it. Right? Yeah. But if it's good, so you give them a platform, and they're responding right now tremendously. Right.
So for people with you know, digital cameras attached to their phones, which is a norm these days, I'm sure they got a lot of pictures to take. And
I agree.
So how many entries per person?
No limit. No, as long as you have the time and the internet connection. But most importantly, you see, you will probably agree that you need MRT because parking is difficult in Kuala Lumpur, it's expensive, $10 an hour. A million other Malaysians have the same reason. Mm-hmm. So it's the picture that's going to make the difference. So if
that's
you,
true.
You know, if you put a picture of just a parking lot, a parking sign that says $10 an hour, it might give you some votes, but if you put you crying next to it, you know, especially U-turns.
Okay.
So you might get voted in, you know. So
that would take a lot to get me crying. Okay. Yeah, maybe $25 an hour would get me crying.
The categories for the contestant to tag. Mm. So how does it reflect?
Well, basically, it's just easier for people to tag comfort, economy, convenience.
See.
It's just for people to be able to tag what is their entry all about? What is the picture all about?
Mm-hmm.
And then people can search on that. And then when people search these buzzwords, we'll get to that website as well. So it's just a platform for people to be able to find the website easily as well.
Mm-hmm. We see the signboards up already as to where the MRT will basically be.
Mm.
There's some confusion as to where it's actually built.
Yeah.
Yasmin thinks there's one near her office.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
an LRT.
Yeah.
I thought there was one in Sultan Ismail. That's a walkway.
That's a walkway. Well,
where exactly will you be built?
Okay, we will be all the way from Sungai Buloh, which is northwest of the city, and then to Kajang, which is the southeast. And this line is 51 kilometers.
Mm-hmm.
We'll have 31 stations, 7 of it underground, and 9.5 kilometers of it is underground. We'll go all the way to, and you know, Cheras with the hundreds of Taman Perumahans there, so we need to be able to come in there.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to go on the main road in Cheras, then we'll go into Jalan Peel, Cochrane, the new Tun Razak Exchange, we have a station there. Bukit Bintang, Jalan Sultan, and then of course KL Central. Then you come out to Damansara Heights, PJ Section 16, Taman Tun, Kota Damansara, the curve. We have a station in the curve, and then all the way Pasiran Surian, which is very long in Kota Damansara. You end up in Sungai Buloh, and then in Sungai Buloh commuter station.
Okay.
Very important. This links with commuter and monorail,
yes.
and of course in KL Central with all the other rail systems in the country.
Yep.
A question for all the female in KL, will they be all female coach?
Not that it's worked so far for the other operators. It's a bit early to say. Remember, MRT Corporation is the owner and developer. The operator will more than likely be somebody else, probably the current operator as well. But I think that's the direction that we should all be looking to. But enforcing that as well can be a challenge, which I read in the papers almost on a weekly basis.
Another question. How about for people with disabilities? Will they be...
It's built to be able to...
be assessed.
To access by people with disabilities. We will provide a lot of bicycle parking as well at the station, so that people can... Because the challenge is to get people to get off their cars. Right. Malaysians, the moment you started work, you will start to aim to buy a car.
Yes.
But in other countries around the region, they don't, because there's a transport system which is good and it links everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Then this question of the first mile connectivity and the last mile connectivity, getting you to the station to get to get to your destination, and then the destination to from your station to the destination. That's another first and last mile connectivity which we are addressing with local authorities and local planners, because you need to get feeder services into the stations.
So how are car manufacturers taking this? Are they sending you pictures as well?
Not yet.
Well, I can imagine they might be crying a little bit. Talk to us about, you know, how long this contest will run for, really.
Okay, we will. We launch it on the 23rd of September. We'll go all the way to 31st December. There are three cycles. Then there's the grand prize after that, which is $10,000.
Wow!
Yeah.
$10,000.
You better tweet, darling.
I've got to start pictures. Since I've already got voting, me crying, you know. So
yeah.
That
but there are many reasons. I think if you put your mind to it, there's many reasons which can be creative reasons which you can execute very well, you know. And I think we need to jog some people's creative minds a bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. This may not be the right question to ask, but for sports fans, we love stadiums. Are there any MRT stations near stadiums?
Well, Stadium Merdeka, there'll be one there. There's Stadium Kajang, there's one there.
Okay.
Since you got into that...
Sorry, Stadium Kajang is only satay for me.
Yes, yes. Real authentic
and satay.
And satay
yes.
for me.
Yeah.
But you see, that's the other thing. You need to have developments around these stadiums, mm-hmm, you know, mm-hmm. around this station so that people can have a function. So we're looking into that. We're looking to how we can encourage people to build around our stations.
Mm-hmm. You know, okay.
So that they have the ridership is secured for the system.
And the feeder services, will they be buses? Will they be
It should be buses. It should mm-hmm. be buses. Mm-hmm. We have not decided on the model because in Hong Kong, for example, the MRT MTR mm-hmm. actually provides also some feeder services.
Mm-hmm.
But for us right now, we're just focused on building the line.
Mm-hmm.
Very excited because in about 4 Decembers from now, mm-hmm. we'll be running.
Wow.
December
2016, we'll be running all the way up to Samantha, Damansara Heights. And then in another 7 months, July 2017, all the way, including the underground. So, and that's just line one, Terrence. Mm-hmm. And,
okay, you also have underground.
Yeah, the 9.5 kilometers from Damansara Heights all the way into Maluri is
wow.
Underground.
Wow, and that's like the, you know, nowadays I think a lot of people literally you know, if I were to go to KL, I have to take an 1.5 hours.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
Time yeah. just to be just on the road.
Yeah.
So, I think
well, typically,
yeah, so why did you vote for cheaper cars anyway?
I did not.
From TTDI, for example, mm-hmm. to Pasar Seni or mm-hmm. KL, which is the heart of old KL,
mm-hmm.
less than 20 minutes with no parking issues. Right.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something which Malaysians have to think about. You don't have to park. You'll be, of course, less contributing less to the carbon footprint of the country,
mm-hmm.
and it's something which has a lot of multiplier effects as well. If you're a trader in Jalan Sultan,
yes.
20,000 people per hour is a tremendous amount of mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. people I can bring to your business. Same in Bukit Bintang, you know.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
If I can bring you 20,000 people with ease, they don't go there all frazzled and, you know, nervy with the traffic jam and parking and everything. So it could be better for them. It
yeah.
should be better.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. I can imagine a lot of convenience stores opening up in every station.
Yeah, as well.
so
okay.
that's fantastic.
How do you join the contest?
You go to the website, which is mrtmyride.com.my.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And what you do is you register. Either if you already have a Facebook account, then it's easier. You just go through your Facebook account, you'll get in. Otherwise, you register, about 10 steps to register, put in a picture of yourself. And I think in about 3 minutes, you're ready to enter. Then you put in a reason. I need MRT because, what was your reason again? And then you put a picture, or you can draw if you like. Draw it and then put it in and get promoted. That's very important. You need to promote it. Cut the link, put it on your
Facebook page,
on your Twitter, on your Twitter. Facebook page, on your... Is there still MySpace around?
Yeah, there is. I don't think it
Justin
has much traffic.
Justin Timberlake is one of the celebrity who endorsed MySpace again.
Ah,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's why the popularity dropped. So,
so again, you click you copy the link and then you post it on your social networks. This is how it's going to be, the viral social effect.
And the first prize will be?
10,000.
That's not the first prize, it's a grand prize.
Grand.
Every month there is a winner of $5,000.
Okay,
and then the final month, you'll have a $10,000 grand prize winner.
And
will there be a very big award
well,
ceremony?
We want to do the awards on site, for example,
okay.
where the construction is being happening. It's happening now, construction is being done everywhere now. But you'll be famous because when you put the ad on the billboard,
yes,
inspired by Terrence or by...
You know? Oh my god, I got a name on a board!
Nice.
With
that
your picture there.
Fame thing, you know?
Yeah.
That's
money, fame, it's almost perfect.
Yeah, it's almost perfect. Money, fame.
So better start tweeting.
Yeah.
5 years of fame, really, because you know, your ad will be up there until 2016.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so it's a big deal. Thank you very much for being on the show with
I'm
us.
Happy
Do you have
to
any
be here.
Final words for the current KL traffic jam citizens?
Well, it's going to get a little bit bad with our construction right now, but you know, it's something which you need to go through
yes.
to get. To a better end, you know? There's light at the end of this tunnel. You will get better traffic in the end. You know, when we build the full 3 lines, we're done.
Mm-hmm.
We'll have a great system in Kuala Lumpur, which we'll talk about. People talk about Singapore and Hong Kong being good public transport. We want people to talk about our system now.
Yes.
Yeah. So give us about 5 years.
All right.
Okay.
That's fantastic. Thank you very much for being
Thank
here.
Thank you very
Thank
much.
You for having us.
And there you go. That's a little bit of pain we have to go through before we can get the gains. The anesthetics for that probably is the contest.
I'm planning to have MRT help me with losing weight. You
why?
Know why? Because 2 hours in traffic jam, I snack like nobody's business.
Okay, well, with the bike
parking. So eco-green.
Yes. Very, very, very interesting stuff.
I'm going to
tweet
that too.
So we're going to have healthier care lights in 5 years' time, thanks to the MRT as well.
And don't forget to join the
contest. As long as those convenience stores don't sell the snacks that you normally snack on.
Oh, yeah. Yo.
Stop. Snack.
Stop snacking.
Get back on. 3 minutes to the office. 3 minutes back to the snack shop. Okay, anyway.